the Sudanese hip-hop group Nas Jota returned to Sudan for a New Year's Eve concert, their first show at home since 2004, when authorities banned their music for being political. Nas Jota, which means chaotic people in Arabic, was forced to flee after former President Omar al-Bashir's government cracked down on artists who called for protest and new leadership. But since Bashir's ouster last April, Sudan's transitional government has welcomed back dissident artists like Nas Jota.
This is the moment that we were looking for, is that finally I can come back to my country, make life a best for my people with no fear. Before, I couldn't.
The musicians are hailing their return with charity concerts marking Sudan Independence Day, January the 1st, the new year and a new Sudan, along with one concert for children with cancer. Some of the artists like hip-hop singer Ayman Mal have been living in the United States and hope to see similar freedoms in Sudan.
In 2020, I wish for the youth in Sudan to have a freedom of expression, freedom of justice, equal rights, especially the artists. I want them to have a Sudan where they can be creative and express themselves.
Returning artists like singer Rasha Shekhadin admit there is still a struggle in Sudan.
I'm so excited. The country feels new, although it's still difficult for everybody. Prices are really high. Life is difficult, but people are happy and hopeful and full of plans for the future. It's fantastic.
Many of the protesters of the December 2018 uprising against skyrocketing consumer prices that led to Bashir's downfall say they listened to the bad music during the month-long popular uprising.
These songs have inspired the youth and encouraged us because they described what was happening. It gave a motivation and a power to the youth.
The concerts continue through mid-January to support relatives of those killed during the crackdown on protesters as well as peace across Sudan. Neba Muhiddin for VOA News, Khartoum.